I-beam. I hope all of you know what an I-beam is. If you guys don't remember, you have seen this beam most commonly in railway tracks. Yes, railway tracks use I-section beams. Today we will try to understand this beam in the simplest way possible. Let's begin. The I-beam is a backbone of any engineering construction. The world famous Segram building, Fujian bridge and Manshan swamp bridge all made possible with the use of this beam. It all started when German engineer Alfons Halbo invented the first I-beam in 1849, and then British engineer Henry Gray perfected this I-beam in 1898 for wider use in the construction industry. Nowadays, we see this beam in bridges, building frames, overhead cranes and many more places. The I-beam is also known as universal beams. But despite all these things, what is it in the I-beam that sets it apart and earns significant value in the industry? Also, what does the shape have to do with the beam? Let's examine each of these factors one by one. The I-beam is extensively used in bridge construction because it offers high strength and less weight compared to other beams. This is also known as the strength to weight ratio. In the chart provided, you can see the strength, weight and the maximum deflection for the different beams. Among all of these beams, the I-beam performs far better in terms of its weight. An I-beam is a combination of single vertical plate supported by two horizontal plates. This shape gives them the ability to carry heavy loads over longer distances. But what does the shape have to do with this? The two horizontal plates called flange will carry the bending moment, with the upper plate or upper flange subjected to compression and the lower plate or lower flange subjected to tension. Additionally, the middle vertical plate called web is provided to carry shear stress. From this, it is clear that the beam is especially designed to carry both shear and bending moment efficiently. Here you can see some of the greatest achievements made using I-beams that we have already discussed in our introduction. Now let's take an example of a simply supported beam and understand it in the easiest way. We will apply 100 kg of uniformly distributed load or UDL over this 5 meter length simply supported beam. The maximum deflection will occur exactly in the middle of the beam. The formula available to calculate the maximum deflection of the beam as follows. Delta L equal to 5WL cube divided by 384 EI. Weight W is 100 kg. Multiply 9.81 for weight to convert the weight into newtons. Length L is 5 meter. Young's modulus E is 200 GPa. This value will change depending on material. Moment of inertia I comes to this value. Please check out my video description for the calculator to calculate the moment of inertia for I-beam. After the calculation, we got the maximum deflection as 2.665 mm. Now we have determined the maximum deflection in the beam is 2.665 mm. However, this value may vary depending on the other factors such as temperature, nature of load and safety considerations. Up until this point, we have only discussed the advantages of using an I-beam. But what are the disadvantages? It is important to note that while the beam is excellent for handling bending and shear stresses, it is not well equipped to handle torsional loads. When a load is acting offset from the neutral axis, as seen in this example, where the load is applied to one side of the beam, the I-beam struggles to handle the torsional load. And a beam is also subjected to buckling if the beam reaches its critical load due to high compressive load, as you can see in this animation. Now you can see one big example of failure of I-beam, the Kansas City Hat Regency walkway collapse. In this disaster, 118 people lost their lives. Overall, only specialized and qualified people in structural design should construct I-beams to avoid such disasters. This is just a brief overview about I-beams. For more information, please check out my new videos in the description. Creating this detailed video took a great effort, so please subscribe and click the bell icon if you like this video. I will be covering more topics like this in the future, so stay updated. Thank you for watching. We will meet in the next video. Bye bye.